Hi, Matthew Carr, Chief Trend Strategist for the Auction Club here. And today, welcome to an episode of Beyond the Bong. This is a segment where I'll delve deeper into the cannabis industry, as well as into certain pot stocks, an area that I've covered, you know, for the past several years. But more importantly, right now we have 420, the high holy day of the cannabis industry. This always sparks interest into pot stocks. On top of that, over the next couple of weeks, we do have industry earnings on deck. But these are just kind of two catalysts that are taking place at the moment. The other is what I call pot smoking season here in the United States. This stretches from March through September every single year. And to illustrate my point, I want to bring up Colorado's monthly sales totals. What we see every single year is that from October all the way through February, sales declined. No one likes to go outside and smoke weed during the winter, apparently. But all of a sudden, as soon as spring gets here, sales in March shoot higher. Those set a record, and then that record will again be set somewhere later in the season, somewhere around August or September, when everybody is outside going to concerts and having a good time. But looking at this data, there's a few things that I want to point out. Number one, this is lagging data, right? So right now, Colorado has not officially released monthly sales totals for March. Number two, the main takeaway, the takeaway I want everybody to focus on here is that April is never a record for sales, despite the fact that it is home to 420, the biggest holiday for the cannabis industry. This is cannabis's Christmas. Those sales largely impact a single day. They don't impact an entire month like the onset of spring or heading out to concerts. And then third, 2020 is going to be a really funky year for the cannabis industry. And I actually do not think we'll see a new record set this March. And here's why. We know that just like with toilet paper, with soup and Spam and all those other things that people love to hoard, everybody went out and they hoarded cannabis. Weed sales jumped during the first 2 weeks of March, and in some instances were up 100% or more. But in those final weeks, when everybody was going practicing social distancing, staying at home, dispensaries were largely closed or just doing curbside pickup, those sales plummeted. And in fact, in Colorado, we know that they're probably going to end up being down compared to year over year. So what does all of this mean? What does 420 mean for investors and for pot stocks? This is where it's another sort of kind of interesting situation. Over the last 5 years, if we look at the US Marijuana Index, which is made up of American marijuana companies, and how it's performed for the 6 months from 420 all the way through October 20th, you get this kind of maybe like Debbie Downer trend. In three of those 5 years, the US Marijuana Index fell 29% or more. The average return over those 5 years is 6.26%, which that doesn't sound super great for a 6 month trend, but it is considerably better than the 1.56% average return we see from October 20th all the way through April 20th. Now, I know those are a lot of numbers, and you're wondering, well, this seems kind of positive. Should I race out and gobble up a bunch of these really cheap pot stocks? And right there, I would say, you know, kind of pump the brakes. You know, this in this environment, because of COVID-19 and the global pandemic, this is a time to be more selective than it is to be speculative, especially with pot stocks. There are issues concerning COVID-19 and sort of the relief money that's going out there, as well as the listing threat, which I'll actually cover in another episode of Beyond the Bong. Those are two kind of dangers that I see lurking, but it's not all negative. But I don't want to be a negative Nelly or harsh anyone's buzz, because there are opportunities. In fact, there are three cannabis companies that I actually really think offer great long-term potential for investors. The first is a company called Canopy Growth Corp. This has been my number one pot stock to own since 2017. It is the biggest and the baddest cannabis company out there. It has all of the celebrities that you could ever possibly want producing brands. We're talking Seth Rogen, Snoop Dogg, Martha Stewart, cover all of those bases. It also has the backing of Constellation Brands, which pumped billions of dollars into the company for infused beverages, and has this massive global footprint. So it's not just this Canadian company. The fact that shares are trading below $15 is really nutty to me. They've been killed this year, along with not just the cannabis sector, but stocks in general. So I actually think this still remains my number one pot stock to own for the long term, because I think we can go back up to those highs that we eventually saw over the past couple of years. Number two is a company called Trulieve out of Florida. This play I like because over the last couple of years, what we've seen in the American multi-state operator sector is growth at any cost. Everybody wanted to expand their footprints as much as possible, make sure that they were in every single state that was legalizing either medicinal or adult use. A lot of that M&A, that frenzy that we saw, well, it's all started to fall apart because as cannabis went into this bear market that's lasted for more than a year, all of those deals started falling apart. And I said 50 to 70% of them would likely be either rewritten or completely negated. And that's what we started to see. Well, Trulieve decided to focus just on one state, Florida. They control more than half of the Florida medicinal market. They just released record fourth quarter results, and they stated that despite the impact of COVID-19, they are seeing those strong medicinal sales. So this is a company that I like here in the US because it is focused on that one state. It owns the majority of that state's market, and it'll eventually be able to build out. And finally, the third company I like is one called Innovative Industrial Properties. This is a real estate investment trust for the cannabis sector. Every time you see medical use legalized in a state or expanded, and Innovative Industrial Properties is there. And what it does is it takes industrial sort of warehouses, converts it into greenhouses, and then leases it to a cannabis producer. Almost all of its square footage is leased, and for 14 years or more. More importantly, though, shares have been cut in half in 2020, and it offers a 5% dividend yield. It is the only pure play on cannabis that offers a dividend. So this is a great company to hold for the long term, and you're going to continue to receive those dividends. There's a lot of value out there that's been created by this bear market, not just broader, but also for the cannabis sector. But there's also a lot of danger and a lot of traps that investors need to be wary of. Still, I think there are some awesome opportunities like Canopy, like Trulieve, like Innovative Industrial Properties that investors can bag for 420 and hold for the long term. I'm Matthew Carr, Chief Trading Strategist for the Oxford Club. Thank you for watching this episode of Beyond the Bong. For more information like this, be sure to go down to the description and sign up for my free e-letter. Until next time, here's to high returns.